Jeremy.
All right, yeah, let's have a look outside right now. Here's Kitty Hawk Pier. We've got some waves coming in already, even though Florence is far to our south, and we're going to have some of these waves. Here it is on satellite. Very impressive. The eye is back. It's pretty pronounced. There's some strong thunderstorms around that center. And you can see, I mean, the clouds stretch far away. You can see land now, a bit ominous that you can actually see land. For a long time, we've been tracking this just over the ocean, but some of the rain bands are already reaching the southern end of North Carolina. So here it is, winds of 130 miles an hour. It's a Category 4 hurricane. It moves towards the Gulf Coast, or pardon me, the coast of North Carolina as we go into Friday morning. 120 mile per hour winds, Category 3, but it does look like it's going to take a hook and move off to our west. Terrible news for down here because it could remain strong for a longer period of time. Then it does finally move inland towards South Carolina. But for us, it is some better news as it would try and move westerly and away from here. Now, even though that's the center of the storm, it still could move a little bit more to the north, and the effects are going to lift north of the storm. So just keep in mind, some of the computer models do have it hooking a little bit off to the north, briefly, and then moving west. So there's still that possibility it could get a little closer to our region. We're going to keep that in mind, at least for a little while. This is our computer model, Future Track, pardon me, and it's got a lot of the rain, the mass of the rain, all moving towards the North Carolina coast as we go later into Thursday. For us, locally, we'd get some of the rain bands at first. That'd be tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow night. And then the bigger area of rain would interact with a stationary front in here that's going to wrap up into this system. That'll happen Friday, and so we could see some of that heavy rain up this way as that interaction between the front, the moisture, all come together. And notice there it is just spinning over North Carolina for a long time. There is going to be flooding down to our southwest. Some of those flooding rains could make it up into our region. As far as the winds go, today we're just fine. We got winds west, east-northeast. Coming in about 5 to 10, 10 to 15 miles an hour near the shore. But tomorrow, the winds will already start increasing. Remember, it'll make landfall probably on Friday down to our south, but north of the system, we're going to get these onshore winds coming in. We're talking about 10 to 20 miles an hour. Gusts could be up to 30, maybe even 35 miles an hour near the shore. And then later tomorrow into early Friday, we could see some gusts 45 miles an hour in Hampton Roads, maybe some gusts even up to hurricane force down closer to Hatteras, closer to the storm. So that'll be happening into Friday. So the effects, 3 to 5 inches of rain, southeast Virginia, 5 to 10 inches possible, parts of North Carolina. I think as you get closer to the Albemarle Sound, that is possible. And west of Hatteras, probably about over 10 inches. Could see some gust here up to 45 miles an hour. That could still cause some limbs to break and some power outages. But I think down towards the southern Outer Banks, that's where there could be potentially some winds gusting up to 70 miles an hour, maybe a little stronger than that. Let's see. But that would be in the gust, not the sustained winds. For the tide, this is important. Lots of folks are wondering about this. The tide in Hampton Roads, 5.5 to 6 feet. That's for Sewell's Point, and that's really for Yorktown, too. That's some moderate tidal flooding. That's not that bad. Isabel was over 7 feet. Hurricane Sandy was 6.81. This will be below those levels. Please, this will be below those levels. But at the same time, we are going to get some heavy rain to come in. It could be on top of the tide. That could cause some flooding in some of these locations, and it could come up a little higher than these levels just because of the rain, a little bit higher. Now, also, the western Albemarle Sound, we're concerned that that wind is going to push that water up into southern Bertie County and southern Shawan County. That may cause some big problems down there, possibly rising up above 3 feet over the ground. So, few rain bands will be coming in Thursday. Squally weather, the breeze picks up. By Thursday night, the winds increase. Rain increases too, at least in coverage, and we'll get a lot of rain and wind on Friday. Probably some moderate tidal flooding. That's what I'm expecting for Hampton Roads, moderate tidal flooding on this one, and that'll be happening mostly on Friday, maybe Thursday night as well. Things should improve then on Saturday. Super Doppler 10, things are quiet right now. We'll just have some isolated showers out there for the afternoon and evening. Not all that much. You got time to get out, prepare, do what you need to do. Tomorrow in the morning, an isolated shower, but you see these rain bands coming in again and again. That's squally weather. The rain picks up, the wind picks up, and the line moves through, and then the winds calm down for a little while. That's what you can expect for tomorrow. Highs today, mid to upper 80s, partly cloudy, isolated showers, not too bad today. Tomorrow, 82, we'll see scattered showers with those rain bands, and then rain is likely on Friday. It'll be on and off through the day, 81, and then things will improve over the weekend. Saturday into Sunday, we'll still have some rain showers, but the rain chances will drop off, and the winds will drop off too. We'll have a full update on this forecast, Wavy News 10 at 4 p.m.